They've been awesome. They're getting ready for St. Joseph's Day
Look
preparation.
At this. And this is the most amazing thing ever.
This is Holy. Guest number one. Please say hello to the mayor.
Hi, everyone.
Kathy Romeo Taken. Thank you so much for being here.
Oh, my God, this is heaven.
And now this.
I have to tell you the whole story about this.
Yeah.
Every year for Lent, I'm Catholic, and every year for Lent, I give up sweets and chocolate, and then I do good deeds. And every day, I do a new good deed for 40 days. Well, because this is my favorite time of year, St. Joseph. Truthfully, I like it better than St. Peter's. And I'll tell you why in a second. It's because, and this is called the Zeppeli, which is supposed to be like this big. And I can't have it until like Easter. And every year she'll make me one specially. And it gets bigger and bigger. Happy birthday to me. Isn't this wonderful?
So now, Maria, this is the first cake, like this size, Zeppeli?
Yeah, ever. No one's ever done one.
Oh, look
this
at that.
This incredible.
Is beautiful.
Excuse me,
thank you so much.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, you know what?
It's really, so what goes into making?
Love.
Of course.
Lots of love.
What's special about this?
It's a traditional thing that they serve for St. Joseph's.
Mm-hmm. It's a cream puff. It's like a cream puff. Mm-hmm. And inside you'll have your yellow pudding, your ricotta, and she makes it with love. So get
and
out here.
Love, and yeah. We put cherries in it, like a cherry filling, and there's ricotta chocolate chips. Normally it's either you can get them with either the yellow cream and the cherries,
yes,
or the ricotta and the cherries, but this time it's all together, all in one,
yeah,
and it's there.
Fantastic. And it's mine, all mine.
It looks beautiful.
No, this would be mine for Easter.
Yeah. That's Maria Cracciolo. Thank you for having us, Maria,
thank you
so much.
The traditions in Gloucester, it's amazing that what we have, and thank you to the community, because the community embraces everyone's different religions and different times, which is so welcome in Gloucester. I am so proud to be the mayor, because it's just all about community, embracing, and, you know, celebrating each other and respecting each other's religion, which is great. Mm-hmm. And this time of year, it's St. Joseph. St. Joseph actually kicks it off before St. Peter, because you got St. Joseph, St. Anthony, St. Peter. Now, how it started off in St. Joseph was years and years ago. St. Joseph, as we know, if people who do know, who don't know, he was the stepfather of Jesus, who believe in Jesus. And so he's a worker. He was a carpenter.
Mm-hmm.
So after World War II, there was famine, and especially for Italians. There was no jobs. And, you know, you went, no Irish or Italians need to apply. And they prayed and prayed, and they started doing altar, please, you're a worker, could you please help us find a job? We will honor you, and we will do that. And so they did. So now what happens is, the night before St. Joseph, which every year it's March 19th, it doesn't matter what day it is, it's March 19th, and the night before, I've been doing this since I was 5 years old. We go around to the altars in Gloucester. Now, everyone either is wanting something because they need something, they might have cancer, they might just the prayers, or they're thanking for the prayers or the miracles that happen in their lives.
Mm-hmm.
So we have 21 in Gloucester. We used to have more. We have 21 in Gloucester. I used to take a trolley, and we used to have the trolley from Cater, and we'd have about there's only allowed 65, but 85 people on the trolley.
Right, yeah.
And we'd go around to all these altars. And when you go, and I still do it this year, but what I do now is, because I'm mayor, I can't put the city at risk of lawsuits or anything else. So I just tell people, you're more than welcome to follow me. So it's your own car, your own vehicle, and you're more than welcome. So I have a list of where we're going to go, the houses, and I usually keep it to 10. And so we'll start off on Washington Street to the Fontanas, and we'll go to the Scholas on Exchange Street, the Shalinos, and Margaret Representative Ferranti.
Mm-hmm.
So they all have all these things in their altars, different things. There is no one altar the same. It's like a snowflake. It's just amazing.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm.
And it's just different women. And you'll have your American Italian, Italians, but they all learn the songs. And you cannot learn it in Italy. They do it, you know, in Italy they have this, and I can show you tons of videos, but they just started again. We've never stopped it. I mean, I have relatives that live across that bridge, and they'll go for the Zeppoli, and they'll go for the spaghetti. And when we were younger, we called it wallpaper paste, because it was really thick, and now they're starting to make it different. And matter of fact, you're more than welcome to join us, because after I leave here, we're gonna go make some homemade spaghetti if you'd like to come join us. And it's open house. Mm-hmm. So the night before, everyone goes, and they give you an orange, a bread, and a lemon in a bag. And what does that stand for? The bread, so you may never go hungry again. An orange, so you'll have a sweet future. And a lemon is never forget your bitter past. Because if you got your wish, you are working, don't forget to help the people that are behind you.
Right.
Never forget your bit of pass. And that's a reminder for everyone every year is, you know what, we may be successful, but don't forget where you started from. Mm-hmm. You one day had famine, you one day want a sweet future, but don't forget your bit of fast. So you can actually help people, and that's how it goes. And that's my best part. Seeing the women still praying and the tradition going on younger and younger, it's just amazing. And like Sunday, Ann Margaret, because she's a state representative, it's hard because they're in house, they're doing things. And so she can't celebrate it the day of St. Joseph. So she wants to make sure everyone has that feast because it's San Giuseppe Cumitao alle poveri uffinelli, adaule preparata o mangiate viginelli, which means St. Joseph, set the table for all and open your doors to all the orphans. Some of the homes in Gloucester, like where I'm going to go make the pasta, on that Tuesday, they open the day to orphans. We don't have orphans, thank you, but we do have homeless. So we open the houses to homeless people, and they come. The night before, she brings all the children, because you're supposed to have the children. In Viginelli, you're supposed to have the children. So she invites all the children in the neighborhood, whoever wants to come to her house, and the priest does a blessing, and she gives them treats. The next day, like I said, it's St. Joseph on Tuesday, and we open the doors for homeless people first, because that's what you're supposed to do. You don't forget. And they come in, and every year they come back, and every year, you know, we open the door, and they say, can I bring a friend, or can I bring this? And some, you know, we give them just a bag to go, because they just don't want to put that foot through yet. And that's okay. That's okay. It's what you want. Years and years ago, the Lombardo family who started in Gloucester, actually, you'd have to go to three houses and knock on the door for all the ones who are listening. You have to go three doors. No, there's no room at the inn. No, there's no room at the inn. And at the third one, you'd have a whole feast. Mm-hmm. But you couldn't eat unless there was people that were homeless or children. Back then, and years ago when it first started, there was orphanages. Mm-hmm. And you'd have to feed the orphanage children first.
Interesting.
And that's the song. And the song's in Sicilian that, you know what, you can't even get it anymore. Some of the songs that they have, when I was telling my Italian cousins, and they're going, I have no idea what you're saying. So I record it, I have it recorded on my phone, and they have to keep going over and over because they don't understand it because it's totally Sicilian. And it's some of it I'm going like, ma, what is this? Sant'Antonino, Guaneda, Nigaredo. I said, that's not even words. And they said, it is to us. And the funny thing about it is, most of the women who sang these songs didn't know how to read or write, but they remember the song. And because I didn't know, and now I found out, is because one lady had her book upside down, and I'm looking, they're going, she doesn't read or write.
Right,
I says,
right.
What? I says, what do you mean? She doesn't read or write. She never learned. She was, I went, okay, I'm not questioning. I'm just surprised because she's a head singer. And they go, well, yeah, well, how do you, about you? Do you remember them? It's like, you know, it's repetition.
Yeah,
and they, all these years. So it's just amazing. I love it. Ken, Ward 2 counselor, is going to come tonight at a feast that they're doing. And so he'll be able to see his first time. And he's more than welcome to come and
to
make the pasta.
On,
yeah.
Right?
Oh, that one, yeah, bring earplugs. That's I think, one of a huge, huge one. That's like probably be about 50, 60 people tonight. I go to a smaller one because she's my kumari, and Mariella is having difficult times in her life, and she thanks God every day. Her son was supposed to lose his eye completely. And she prayed and prayed and prayed, and he has perfect vision in that eye. So whether you believe or not, she did, and that's great. And, you know, she had some other trouble times. We all had trouble times. You know, my brother, I'm praying good and hard. I get emotional, lung cancer. Mm-hmm. And we're just praying for everyone who has cancer and dealing with it. We're losing a lot of friends this week. We know them in hospice, and we're breathing. And I sent them all a little St. Joseph in the text and telling them, you know, we're praying for you. And it's just amazing. And every house that I go to, if you ask, you put the person's, get a little piece of paper like that, put your wish on it or your prayer, and you put it there, and each house they'll say a prayer for that person. It's just amazing.
That's lovely.
You go to the Marino house on Williams Court.
Mm-hmm.
Now when you walk in that house, that room,
I know that house,
yes,
well.
Yes, you walk in that house and there's 50 women.
Yeah.
And they actually look forward to my group that comes because we do the old Sicilian songs and say this one and bring a new one and bring a new song. And so what it is because they have the old fashioned songs, I bring them new songs every year. And we'll sing to it, and they love it, and it's just music to our ears. It's just the work that goes into it. Now, for a lot of people who don't like the conza, we call it the conza, the wallpaper paste, and they're going, I can't take that. It's a ritual now. The pan, I kid you not, is from here. So I have like a wooden spoon that's like this big, going like this, and it's amazing. And then it is cauliflower, mm-hmm. broccoli, chickpeas, kidney beans, cavallini beans, lentils, the fennel, fava beans. Now you have to cook each one separately, and then you put it in this humongous pot. Then the spaghetti separate. And so we'd also make it with the zugu, for anyone who wants to call it something different, we're not allowing it, but yep. zugu, or red sauce, for the children who just don't want that.
It's an acquired taste. For
Well, you know what? It's getting better and better in some houses because they add their own little uniqueness mm-hmm. to it, mm-hmm. and some don't add all of it, but they mm-hmm. add just the cauliflower, the main greens. You have to have the chickpeas and the fava beans or it's not St. Joseph.
Oh, yeah.
But what's happening is that, the younger generation is actually improving, it's not so thick anymore. It's just the fact that they all prepare ahead of time. They prepare for the 9 days of the novena. Mm-hmm. 100 pounds of spaghetti that they make, I mean, and the old-fashioned way, because you get the Sicilian women, they don't want machines. I'm better than a machine, they say. I do it with love. I don't have you kids get it easy, and then she'll show us how to do it. And when they roll it up, and I actually put it on my Facebook, they roll it up, they get this big thing, very, very thin, and they're rolling it with all their heart, rolling it out very, 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 very thin, and then you roll it up, like you got like a rolled up piece of paper, and then you top it. And she's like a machine. And I'm going like, wow. And she goes, huh. She loves the gratitude. But hearing their stories, I love it because I get to spend all day with them, listening to the stories when they started theirs, mm-hmm. listening to the stories why they did it. And it's like, to me, it's like better than any educational programs you can have. There's no documentaries of this. There's nothing around the city to listen to the stories and while they're still alive, because some of them is 86 years old. Mm-hmm. I mean, Maria is 86 years old, and she wants to make sure she goes to all the altars. And what she does, Maria Malafoy, she next week will make it in herself, all by herself at home, and bring it to the senior center so they all can try it.
That's
wait
amazing.
For her. Yes, and you know what? I mean, we have amazing people here, and totally. You know, it's about feeding people.
Right.
Yeah, that's why if you go to my parents' house now, you'll just see the Bista. Yep. Drying out all over all the furniture, yep. two or three different rooms.
Hey.
That's what I grew up with.
Well,
you know?
Yeah, well, every clothes basket, you didn't have clothes in it, you had pasta hanging.
Yeah, right.
Every back of a chair, every bed had a tablecloth with all the pasta on it. And that's what we're doing today is she says, Father, I couldn't get this, but I have this. I got the 2x4s. I got this. We have all set. And, well, her father had to leave for 4 days because she took over his whole bottom apartment. All pasta is going to be all over. And anyone can come. We're at 1 Maple Street. You're more than welcome to come. It is open house. I'll be there. And it's just amazing because now she is inviting people that she goes to the YMCA. She does, in the morning, she has gym classes or swimming classes. And they said, we'd like to see it. So they're all going to be there for the first time. And you know what? Like I said, our community is so unique. On the ferry, we've had a lot of Jewish families come with us because mm-hmm. they want to see what our culture is about and what it is. You don't have to believe what we believe in. They're just astonished of what we believe in and the details and the length that you have to go to do all this because it's a procedure of every day of doing something. And it's just like I said, I just love this time of year. Don't get me wrong, I love the St. Peter's. It's great for, you know, tourism, da, da, da. But this is us.
This is special, too.
This is a special celebration.
This is really, this is the heart. This starts it off. This is our faith. This is, mm-hmm. this is every altar has their own tears. Mm-hmm. And everyone is most, I mean, I went to Sister Felicia's. I've never seen such an altar. It's, I think, 15 feet high, 18 feet wide. She wanted to do one like the a village. Mm-hmm. Well, the one that was in the village was outside. She put it inside, and you know.
I saw pictures of that. It was
it's
really
just
remarkable.
Like, wow.
All those
and
beautiful little breads she made.
Yeah, and she has a table of, say, for people who want to get better or have something in their heart that they desire. And then she has people who passed, and so that's good. But if you look at these little breads, these little breads from now on will never get old or moldy. And I'm going to tell you a trick. Mm. If those of you who are going to come with me on the night of the eve, and you get a St. Joseph roll, some are made, some come from Virgilio's, come from Scalafani, some come from here, don't eat it. Leave it on your counter. Watch it. It does not get moldy. It gets hard. And it never changes. And they say if you have something in your heart, or if you have something that's worrying you in your mind that you need some help, break a little piece and say a prayer and watch what happens.
That's beautiful.
And all during the fishermen, when they used to do that, they heard hurricanes were coming and the wind, you would see all the Italian ladies outside with their bread and doing this chanting and this prayer. Please, you know, let our fishermen come home to safety. Please let the winds go away. And we swear that when they did that, you ever see these beautiful rainbows? They told us it was them. And we all believe that after they did all this enchantment that the rainbow was coming. I don't
know, say that it's not.
You know what? Right? Hey, I have wonderful members. So every time I see a rainbow, some people say there's, you know, a lucky charm at the end. It could be an Irish, it could be whatever else. But
well,
I'm
St. Patrick's Day is on Sunday.
That's right.
We're pretty close together. The Italian and the Irish.
Well, we're saying San Patricio. He's Italian anyway, so we don't care. That's what they're all saying. There's a joke around St. Patrick's Italian. So, you know, wherever you go, you're going to be one.
Yeah. Right.
Wherever you go, yeah, you're
welcome.
Yeah, the Irish claim St. Joseph, too.
That's right. So, yeah. So, it's like I said, this, I can't wait for Easter because I just want to go, woo!
But
it's just amazing. And she makes homemade pasta here for people.
Mm-hmm.
And on St. Joseph, you know, she has the same conzer. We call it the conzer. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're more than welcome. I can go on all day about everything. I can go on all day. I'm looking forward Sunday to Aunt Margaret. Says, Aunt Margaret, I'm going to come right away because then I got to go to O'Malley School because don't forget Mary Poppins is playing. And those kids, 73 students, okay, put their heart and soul to do Mary Poppins. So it's this three cast, and this mayor doesn't disappoint a child. I'm going to all three casts.
Right.
So Sunday's the last cast. So I says, Aunt Margaret, I love you. I love St. Joseph, but I'll bring off what I have to bring off to the cast, and then I'll come eat. And so, and then tonight's Sister Felicia, she has a private family gathering. Mm-hmm. And then on Tuesday, every other house that you know in Gloucester will have an open house and we'll be having it cooking. And you just go to the houses and see the women and see the nobody's tired. I mean, they worked all the night before because you have to cook all of those different vegetables and legumes separate. And you have to be careful because if you leave them out, they can go bad. So you're watching it. So it's like, it's just amazing, and it's hard work. So they get up 3 o'clock in the morning, whoever owns that house, and starts doing all the mm-hmm. cooking, and make sure the pasta's dry, and make sure it's this, and make sure it's that, and going all around, and make sure they have enough, and make sure they all got their Tupperware, and make sure they bring their recycle bags, and make sure that, you know, they're doing all that, because we give a lot away.
Right.
Well, it's this beautiful combination of humility and gratitude, and it seems like all of this work leading up to the feast is just all about gratitude, and who can,
absolutely.
You know, everybody needs gratitude. Everybody needs humility. We can learn so much from
you
this.
You know
festival.
What? That lemon and orange and bread.
That's a beautiful tradition.
It reminds
I didn't know
you
about
all that. Yes.
Yeah. I love the lemon with the bitter past.
My grandmother would tell me too, because every time she would get the lemon, she goes, "How many people are forgetting?" When you know, we always use lemon or tea or this, and she'd sit there and laugh. And like, I'll grate some lemon to put in cookies, and she's grating the lemon. She goes, "Do you remember?" And I'm going like, you know why how we got the lemon, and you know why the lemon? And, you know, she remind me. She goes, "Did you forget your past?" I'm going like, "Does she know something I don't know? What about my past?" And she says, no, I'm not talking about what you do with your friends. And she's saying, and she's right. As a mayor, you don't forget. Someone says, you know, you're always out there because you don't forget your past. I mean, I started off as a social service worker. I started off at the hospital. So, yes, I had them in my office. Yes, I do that. Yes, I'll go to the homes. No, nothing's changing. I may be your mayor. I have a great team. We lead the city. Mm-hmm. But that's that. And then the mayor likes to be hands-on, and I love to work with the people.
So what are we going to do with this amazing...
Yeah, get a spoon and dig in because I'm crying right now.
They call me Two Forks Kookaroo.
Yeah, right? I'm driving. Maria! Hey, Ken, you want a peach? You're going to say hello to everyone?
Yeah.
Yeah, you want a knife? You want a...
Are you going to cut that right now?
Yeah, we are. I want to just go like this.
We're
going to
cut this?
I just want to put my finger all through and say tough.
Is everybody ready for a little bit of this?
A promise is a promise.
The Zeppoli cake. Phenomenal.
The Zeppoli cake.
Oh my God.
Don't ever do that in front of me
again.
You know,
I bet people are going to be wanting this. I bet people are going to want this.
This is amazing. She's definitely going to make this for me for Easter, and definitely I want this for my birthday. This is my new birthday cake. This is it.
Yeah,
this is
really.
It. Just put a candle in there, and I'm heaven.
Yeah. When we started talking to Maria about doing the show down here, literally this hasn't been off of my mind for the last 2 weeks.
I know. You keep talking about it.
She kept saying, I got a surprise for you, because every year, like, it starts off this one, and last year she made me two these size. And every year she says, you know what? She goes, I got a surprise for you. I'm going, don't mess with me. You know, she knows I give it up. So that's why she goes, no, I got one that you're going to be happy.
Yeah. So, Maria, we could also move this. Cut the first one.
Do whatever you need to do.
Yeah, cut the first one, and then we can move
it. So, Safatha, we thank you so much for taking
the
time today.
Thank you for the beautiful stories. What a lovely thing.
This is torturous.
This is torturous, yes.
We wish everyone a lovely St. Joseph's.
But can I want you to try this. And when you try this, you realize this is not sugar. You'll think, oh, with all of that in it, it's so sweet, I'm not going to be able to eat it. It's not. This puff is not sugar. the pudding is not sugary. The ricotta is not sugar. Mm-hmm. We only add a little bit of sugar as the confectionery, the chocolate chips, and the cherries.
Oh my God.
Happy birthday, everyone. Happy birthday. I want everyone to try it who's here.
Wow.
You got to come try a piece.
That's crazy.
We don't do anything small. What are you talking about? Cut a small. Get a piece and cut it all yourselves. Get a fork. Jack, do we do anything small, Jack? Absolutely. Is Jack who used to own Palazzolo's? He never did anything small. Jack. We don't do things small. Hi, sweetie. And if you look around the room, you know this cafe always has different cultures, different people, and we all embrace. You know, it doesn't matter what time of day you're going to come in. I love coming in the summer because that's when tourists is, and you have Toodles, so she does a tour guide with the food.
Oh, right, right.
And I've always meet, and it so happens when she has it, I'm here, and she has that fork, and that huge fork, I'm going, I need it for this. And it's great, and I love meeting the tourists, and I love it. And don't get me wrong, every bakery we have in Gloucester makes a unique thing.
Oh, yeah.
They have their best thing. You know, Jim's Bagel's making his, Virgilio makes theirs, everyone has cannolis. We're so fortunate in Gloucester, if one's closed, just jump to the other.
No, it's true.
And then you have the ones who make the best scones. I mean, everyone is unique. We are so fortunate in Gloucester. Someone says, what's your favorite place? Gloucester. They're going to know, what bakery? Gloucester. No matter where you go, Gloucester. You can't go. We have the best restaurants, the best bakeries, the best coffee. You want espresso, fine. You want a reggae. We're so lucky.
Mm-hmm.
We're just so lucky because there's not a place in Gloucester that you can say, ooh. Except right. City Hall and
this
Durham
is
City
just
Hall.
This is just a beautiful work
Sorry.
Of art. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. So I want to see your expression. I want you to try
you
a piece. Get a bite.
Did you have a bite?
That's you. No, take a bite. Take a bite. We want to see how he likes
it. Ken, turn this way. Ken.
We're breaking you into St. Joseph, Ken.
Oh, good. Oh my God. Where do I start with this?
Yeah. Good luck.
Oh, see you, Americans.
Yeah.
What? Look at this.
Dude, nice. That would have been, that's done. Mitigani, they call it. Mitigani. Ah, that a boy. Be Italian.
I'll just do this.
Yeah.
Nice. All nice. Right.
Have a good day, everyone. I'm going to go cut this up.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, that was great.
Sapathia, appreciate
so, Sapathia, yeah, just yep. Yeah.
There's the Zeppelin. Thank you, Ken.
Oh, it fell on me.
That was awesome.
Oh,
that
oh it fell on me. Maria,
that was something.
That was amazing.
Yeah.
Thanks, Sapathia, for being on.